community members, Simpiwe, saw this logo video that we did, and he wanted to find out, can we combine three letters instead of two? Simpiwe, we've come up with three ideas for you. The first one is this gold slanting logo that we're going to do together from Canva. The second one that we're going to create is the gaps logo that we love doing in this channel. And then the last one is this edgy kind of a design that we've created together. I hope this is going to inspire you, Simpiwe, and anybody who's watching. Let's jump in on Canva and create these logos. For our first one, we're going to layer our letters to create a unique design. We're going to create a blank logo canvas, and we're going to press T for text. And the font that we're using is 10 Moncherry. You're then going to use your capital letter K, make the size of your capital letter bigger. And then we're going to change the color of this one and make it gold. We're going to make it nice and big. And we're going to duplicate the shape, and we're going to make that an S. Then we're going to nicely align it to our logo and have them interact with each other and touch each other so nice and gentle. And we're going to duplicate the last one, and we're going to use our M, and we're going to rotate the M. Who said that conventional is always right? That's why we're designers, right? We come up with our own little designs, and the whole thing with logos, it needs to be memorable. That's why we are designers. If you want, you can add a tagline. So we can press T for a tagline, and we'd say tagline. Let me know in the comments below what you think. You would download this design, and you're going to jump in on Photopea and convert it to 3D. Of course, download it as a transparent background. And as usual, you can go to my link below and go try it out. Overlapping letters and overlapping logos are still one of the beautiful ways of showcasing your work and representing your brand. So for this one, you're going to press T for text, and you're going to change the size and make it 170. And then you're going to type the capital letter K. And then you're going to change the font and make it Montserrat Classic. And we're going to duplicate this shape and make M. And then we're going to duplicate the last shape and make an S. But for the font of the S, we're going to go with a beautiful font called Vida Loca. It's got that funky, nice bubble S that I would like to use. And then we're going to change the color of the logo and make it a nice blue and red. Now we're going to overlap these letters and create a gorgeous gaps in between. If you want to learn this technique, go watch this video, but it works using your shapes and making sure that the shape color is white. So what you would then do, you would align them. And now we're gonna start creating our gaps. We're gonna use the circle shape, and we're gonna change the color of the circle and make it white. And then start aligning it on our logo letters so that it creates the gap that we want. So you're going to reduce it, move it ever so gently. Click on your position to see where it's sitting. And if you're happy with how it is creating and the size of the gap, you can leave it as it is. If you're not, you can just go back to your position and bring the S backward, so that you can adjust your shape to exactly where you want it. Next, you're gonna continue doing this on all of the corners until they are all creating the gaps that you want. Then we're gonna search for a curve. If it's controlling
get through. I just gotta get through. Cause I feel like taking off, find a place with a view. The pain is never gonna stop if it's controlling you. I know the time can heal it all, I just gotta get through. Sometimes I feel like all is lost, but I know it's not true. I wanna put up all my walls cause I'm not in the mood. But then I cut myself off from the rest of the room. I know that time can heal.
Once you're done, it should look something like this. And the S should be on top. All of your shapes should be at the back and they should be white. Then you're going to go share and you're going to download it as a transparent background. And if you don't have a transparent background, you can trial it using my Canva link at the bottom of the page. And you're either going to add an extra page if you're using Canva Pro. If you're not, then you can use remove.bg. You're then going to add the shape to our uploads. It will have all of those whites on it, even though it has a transparent background. You're going to size it and you're going to click on edit image and you're going to remove the background. And your gaps look like that. So if you're not happy how the gaps have turned out, you can make it a little bit big and then you can click on erase and take a little bit off, and you can put in restore to restore that little blue on there. So that's what you would do until you get the desired effect of what you want. But I'm gonna do a little bit of adjustments because I'm not 100% happy with the way that it has created the gaps for me. Once you're happy with your design, you're going to download it as a transparent background. And then you are able to jump in on Photopea and convert it to 3D. We're going to select PSD templates and we're gonna find a nice mockup for this one. We're gonna double click where it says your logo. We're gonna hide the text. We click and we drag our logo, we size it. We convert it to smart object by pressing Command S or Control S. Awesome. We click on the first tab that says 3D glass window logo and we wait, and your KSM logo is created and it looks stunning. You're then going to go file, export it as a PNG or a JPEG depending on where you want to use it, and I usually reduce the width and the height so that it doesn't pixelate and it's better quality. And I click on save and my logo is done. We are going to create this edgy logo for Simpiwe. Simpiwe, you must let us know out of the three which one is your favorite. This one you could add a border if you want to add on the edge, or you could leave it without the border. But how you would do that, you would open a blank logo canvas and then you're going to press T for text. And you're going to be using our beautiful font called Major Mono Display. And then you're going to press and add your K, make it nice and large, change the color and make that red. And duplicate your K so that it is a M. And you have your K and your M. Now you're good to go. You're going to go file and you're going to download page 3 as a transparent background. Next, you're going to add on the design to our uploads, and then you're going to add it back to our design. What we want to do here is to create that nice edge. So you're going to crop the extra space out, make it large so that it's similar size, and then you're going to crop out the rest of the K so that you end up with a design that looks like that. Then you're going to move it ever so gently to your K to create that nice little edge that we're looking for. Next, we're gonna add the design again and we're gonna make our M nice and big, as the same size as the M of the font and the letter we've created, so that everything is aligned and it's the same size. Next, we're going to delete the M because we want to use the image M, as we want to create that lovely edgy look and feel. So then you're going to crop out the M and create that nice edge kind of a look, and then size it a little bit. Then you're going to duplicate that shape edit just below your M and then delete the rest so that it looks beautiful like that. Then you're gonna go to your elements and you're gonna look for S, and you're gonna be searching for a graphics S. Then you're gonna scroll down and until you find an S that looks edgy as well, and then you change the color and you make it either a nice gray or a white. Like that, KSM. Then you're gonna press T for text, and we're gonna be using the open source semi bold for this one, and we're gonna change the color and make it a nice gray and write the name of the business. So I've decided Simpua's business is Digital Genie. And your design looks like this. If you would like to add a border, all you do, you press L for a line, and then you decide how big of a line weight you want, and then you can add a border. So I'm gonna leave it like that. And that's as easy as that. It's beautiful, it's done. You're gonna go share, and you're gonna download it as a transparent background. It is our page 3, and you're good to go. Next, you're gonna go to www.photopea.com. We have used a PSD file that we've downloaded from graphicsfamily.com for this one. It looks very beautiful thanks to Graphics Family. If you want to watch another video that's going to teach you and give you more ideas, go watch this one on the screen. Thank you for joining me today.